70. Another one who's bastardizing the truth. If the younger generation you're talking about, the ones with sharp teeth, who are much younger, had not attempted to bastardize the truth, there probably would not have been the need for an apology. Listen, I'll tell you only two things. Many years ago, after we left office, the government attempted to regionalize recruitment. In the Volta region, they went and recruited 40 people. Go back and read what the misrepresentation that took place. And let me see if I can even take into account what I'm going to tell you and compare it to what the baby with the sharp teeth actually did. Attempted to recruit 40 people from the Volta region. When they registered their names, a little while later, every single one of them was sent home. So some of the officers from the Volta region and people in the Volta region thought they are recruited uneducated illiterates. Because we're looking for educated people. So they assumed that when they came to the Volta region, all they did was to employ people like that, recruit people like that, who couldn't qualify, who had no qualification, and would send home. And I had to tell one or two of the officers, please wake up. You seem to be unaware of what you're dealing with, just like in 79. What's a revolution? A revolt? A revolution? It's an explosion against a system that preceded it. So don't expect that system to love the revolution or the revolt. They will do everything to dismantle it, just as they attempted to dismantle the revolution today or tomorrow. It will continue in very cunning ways. They recruit 40 people, send them all home. An officer who's so naive could not understand what had happened. I'll tell you what, they had recruited 40 well-qualified students, took their certificates and attached it to illiterates or semi-illiterates from another region. That is what the baby with a sharp tooth should have said. And not just put out the silly nonsense he put out, which was meaningless, that nobody could understand. Do you understand where I'm coming from now? Or you don't? Let me give you another example of a story I told again. To the chiefs, ladies and gentlemen, as a small boy, I remember my grandma used to talk about, oh, if it's unfortunate in their left country, they could stir some bamboo, prepare some hot water with salt, and you can use it as soup, you dip the bamboo in it. I never thought this kind of poverty would still be found in my country. When I heard the Member of Parliament campaign around the river area where I stay, I was talking about this kind of impoverishment, this kind of poverty, which is just not right. That people should still be eating this kind of thing. Nothing to accompany that raw bamboo. Only hot water and salt. Not long after, a gentleman, Mr. Kluchi, discovered an attempt at some huge plantation by Gaddafi's people. Somehow, it didn't work out. And the land had been left abandoned till he discovered this thing a few years back. said, let's talk to the government to pass on this fund to us so we can invite the poor farmers or the fisher folk to tend to the ground, to plow it and cultivate something so they can eat. It's a shame that we should be in this community and something like this should be happening under our own government. Go and read this story too and see how the baby with the sharp tooth presented it. What happened? We wrote for 1.5 years. We kept chasing our own government to loan out, release this farm. Eventually, what did they do? Some people among them took the baby. Yes. Yes. And you listen. In those areas, when you want to buy a strip of land, let's say this is the stream, the river, and this is the land. You want to buy a strip of land, they sell it to you this way. You come, you also buy a strip this way, so that all of us can have access to the water, right? What your people did. They bought the strip of land, not in this direction, they bought it this way. They bought it this way. Your greedy, selfish people, our people, took over. The next thing, a foreign firm had moved in and actually bought the strip this way, not even the whole land, just this. So that when you come, and you want to buy a strip, you will have no access to the water. So that with that, they have a complete monopoly of the whole damn thing. I have so much on my chest. And you misrepresent me. You bastardize the truth. And people wonder, is this man crazy? And I have to apologize. It's not over. It's not over. My generation to hand over. I'm just giving you an example of what that generation is capable of doing. What a misrepresentation.